It's the E-Commerce Minute, your daily dose of e-commerce, tech, and retail news with your hosts, Bart Meraz and John Suter. The E-Commerce Minute is a production of Sumo Heavy, a digital commerce consulting firm in Brooklyn, New York, and Philadelphia. Find us on the web at sumoheavy.com. This episode of the E-Commerce Minute is brought to you by SendPro Online from Pitney Bowes. With SendPro Online from Pitney Bowes, it's just click, send, and save for as low as $4.99 a month. Send envelopes, flats, and packages right from your desk, and you're back in business in no time. And for being a loyal E-Commerce Minute listener, you'll receive a free 30-day trial to get started and a free 10-pound scale to ensure that you'll never overpay. Save time and money on mailing and shipping with SendPro Online. Starting at $4.99 a month, you can qualify for special USPS rates for letters and priority mail shipping. Calculate exact postage online and print labels right from your PC. So go to pb.com/minute to access this special offer for a free 30-day trial plus a free 10-pound scale to get started. That's pb.com/minute. Experience shipping made simple with a free trial of SendPro Online from Pitney Bowes. It's E-Commerce Minute episode 530.
In today's episode, eBay to launch fulfillment service for sellers.
In the e-commerce world, it's as if the root of retail giants' yearly planning involves from one simple question: how do we defeat Amazon? Companies continually take swings at them, but Amazon seems to find a way to bounce back every time. The latest giant retailer to take on Amazon is eBay, who plans to launch a new shipment and fulfillment service. eBay will launch the new service in 2020 called Managed Delivery that will allow high-volume sellers to store, pack, and deliver orders through a network of pre-approved third-party vendors. eBay isn't planning to build its own warehouse network like Amazon. Instead, it will use the collective volume of its sellers, which is about 1.5 million packages a day, to negotiate discounts with logistics partners, warehouse space, packing, and delivery. Ultimately, eBay wants to let their merchants store inventory in warehouses around the U.S. so products can be delivered in 2 or 3 days to compete with Amazon's lightning-fast delivery. eBay's product pages will have labels that show which products are eligible for fast and free shipping. Sellers can use the service for their sales on eBay, as well as their sales on other marketplaces and their own websites, and items will ship in eBay-branded boxes. Sellers in the program will be charged a fee for warehousing and for shipping once an item is sold. The new service will also be cheaper than Amazon's, and eBay will take responsibility for products lost or damaged in shipping, which is currently the seller's responsibility. eBay is calling managed delivery part of its ongoing evolution to create a more managed marketplace, moving towards more control over supply chain services. It's a big move by eBay.
Yeah, I mean, it's following basically Shopify's move, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, it's well, so I'm actually glad they're doing this, even though Shopify's doing it too. It's not even... in my opinion, it's not going against Amazon. It's actually going against all these three-party logistic companies that have no idea what they're doing. You know, over the
can
years,
you expand on that? Like, what? Why do you?
So,
say?
Yeah, I mean, we've over the years, our clients use third-party logistics or 3PLs, and we've always had issues with their technology and how they're shipping, and it's also not accessible to small vendors because. If you ever look at, this is why Shopify did it, and their big, huge explanation is, you know, if you've ever looked at a contract from a 3PL, it is absolutely crazy. It's like 50 pages of things, right? Because it's like, how much storage do you need? How much this? How much that? And it's all over the place. And it's frustrating. And if you're a small vendor and you're relying on 3PL to ship stuff out, you know, you're kind of mercy at them when it's delivered. So having access to a good technology like Shopify's or apparently eBay's now is a game changer for them.
Yeah, it seems like eBay's finally woken up. They're shedding some of their questionable investments. I heard they're going to unload StubHub. I don't know if that was a rumor. I know that they got rid. What did they just sell recently? But anyway, I think they're finally waking up. It's funny. I was listening to a podcast the other day about Amazon, and they were recalling a time back when eBay's market cap was bigger than Amazon. And I think they just kind of fell asleep for a couple of years and started doing stupid things and making investments in.
Yeah. I mean, investments like in. Right. I mean, they spun out. I think they needed to wake up because PayPal was driving a lot of their revenue, right? So yeah. As soon as PayPal got spun out and then they spun out that whole commerce side of it, it just now they have to catch up.
Yeah. And I think they're doing a good job. But again, as we said before, eBay still has that connotation of where you buy, you know, broken analog telephones and you know, cheap watch bands and stuff like that. There are other competitors, but I think it's still the premier place for people to sell, you know, vintage kind of stuff or collections of things. But as we've seen in the last few years, they've really made a push towards new products. And I think they want to be that place where when you're price comparison shopping, it's eBay, Amazon, or whoever else. And there's going to be a story in a couple of days we're going to do about the Google shopping portal, which if you're interested in that, stay tuned, because that's another interesting thing that's happening in e-commerce right now. But Bart, you mentioned the Shopify logistics service. The Shopify service, that's very similar though. They're still using a network of third parties, correct?
Yeah, it's not there. So it's going to be a network of third parties. And apparently from what I've heard, overheard, because I drink coffee and I know things.
That's Bart's phrase. I drink coffee and I know things.
is that apparently a lot of 3PLs approached them, because what's going to happen is I think what they're doing is giving the software to the 3PLs, which makes sense, right? The connection software and stuff like that. So it's and they're giving it to them for free on return to get all the data, which makes sense if you're a small shop, when you're a small retail store where you can, you know, you can't really afford, first of all, just a big 3PL, but also be a 3PL that is across the country. And what they'll do is distribute them themselves. So say you're ordering a coffee mug from in New York, and the closest, and you're a, you know, a consumer in San Francisco, you know, then you have to ship it from New York to San Francisco, right? But in this whole model is that it's going to be whatever the closest 3PL is, and they'll adjust the inventory and how it goes. So that it's a lot of, you know, a lot of technology in the back end, but they make it seem easier for the clients or the retailers and from consumers.
Yeah, I think this is great. Let's get back to eBay for a second. So there's an example we have in here. It's a shipping to California from New Jersey would take several days. Postage alone to ship a watch band to California from New Jersey costs $309, which doesn't include the packing supplies. Now, a lot of people, I mean, in eBay, that's a very sensitive thing, because when you sell something for a dollar, well, it's I got to pad an envelope. I got to get the tape. I got to post through this service. If you're dealing in volume, obviously this is only for higher volume sellers. But even if it's just something like a watch band, they could do it for $3.99, and everyone handles all the storage, packing, logistics, all that kind of stuff. Which I think, if you're a seller again doing some sort of volume on eBay, this is great. The complaints have been recently, and we talked about retail arbitrage people. Mm-hmm. There was a great article, I think, in Fast Company about these vagabonds that basically travel around the country and do the retail arbitrage. And they're not making as much money anymore because the fees on Amazon are just going up and up and up. I would love to see how this compares, or if this is going to maybe have some of that type of business shift over to eBay.
Yeah, hopefully. It's going to be interesting.
All right, Brittany, why don't you tell us about today's sponsor?
Shipping and mailing from your desk has never been simpler than with SendPro Online from Pitney Bowes. With SendPro Online from Pitney Bowes, it's just click, send, and save for as low as $4.99 a month. Send envelopes, flats, and packages right from your desk, and you're back to business in no time. And for being a loyal e-commerce Minute listener, you'll receive a free 30-day trial to get started and a free 10-pound scale to ensure that you never overpay. So save time and money on mailing and shipping with SendPro Online. Starting at $4.99 a month, you can also qualify for special USPS rates for letters and priority mail shipping, calculate exact postage online, and print labels and stamps right from your PC. So go to pb.com/minute to access this special offer for a free 30-day trial plus a free 10-pound scale to get started. That's pb.com/minute. Experience shipping made simple with a free trial of SendPro Online from Pitney Bowes.
You know, one thing we didn't mention about eBay is that compared to Amazon or even Walmart.com, when you buy something, you're generally getting it from Amazon or Walmart unless it's a third-party seller. But even then, Amazon's got their kind of sticky fingers in there. eBay has always had that hands-off kind of thing. So it's, I need this thing, but I'm not sure when I'm going to get it. Because the guy might be having it in his basement somewhere, and he's got to wipe the cat fur off of it. And it's like, it's always been that kind of like, you buy it on eBay, and then you kind of cross your fingers and hope it gets there. I mean, I've had great experiences on eBay. I've been an eBay seller since 1999, so I'm pro eBay. But I think this point here is that the perception from people is it's not that it's because Prime, everyone just thinks Prime. I want to buy something. I need it now. I need my face cream. I got to have it tomorrow. I'm not going to wait for this guy to pull his box of face cream out of the basement somewhere and wait 2 weeks for it, because that's what happens a lot. So I think this is, and it'd be interesting to see how they promote this, but I'm sure once we start going on eBay and see the fast and free shipping, which they're going to try to probably do some sort of branding around it, like Amazon, we'll see how the perception changes from there.
Cool.
Stat time. eBay has more than 180 million shoppers globally who spend about $100 billion annually on the marketplace. Amazon's global e-commerce sales this year will be more than $340 billion, according to eMarketer. And I'm going to recommend a podcast for you guys, even though, you know, we shouldn't be recommending things. We shouldn't.
We should recommend things.
But there's a podcast called, stand by.
Can't find it.
This is going well.
From Recode, called Land of the Giants, and they're basically going to do a mini series on each of the big tech giants out in Silicon Valley. And in this month's set of episodes, they're doing the sort of the history of Amazon, and it's really, really interesting. And as I mentioned earlier in the episode, they talked about how eBay's market cap was much bigger than Amazon's at one point, and then Amazon completely eclipsed them. But this series is pretty interesting. It's called Land of the Giants. Go check it out. Do you guys have anything else to add?
Nope.
No, sir.
Bart took a deep breath, and he was going to say something, and then he was like,
thoughts have crossed minds, and they now left. So there's that.
They've been replaced by the prayers.
Okay, fair enough. Shiny object. Yeah. Shiny objects. All right, we'll leave it at that. That is your e-commerce minute for today. We'll see you on the internet tomorrow. That's it for today's show. If you like the show, do us a favor and subscribe or leave us a review on iTunes. And don't forget, you can now listen to the e-commerce minute on your Amazon device. Just add e-commerce minute to your flash briefing. And finally, if you have a comment or suggestion, or just want to say hi, find us on social media at Sumo Heavy.